If you like the video, please subscribe Technical PCT channel and click the bell icon to get the latest videos.
Good morning, everyone. So in the last week, nomenclature of haloalkanes almost complete. Types of haloalkanes and alkyl halides. So alkyl halides are mainly classified into three types: primary alkyl halide, secondary alkyl halides, and tertiary alkyl halides. Based on halogenatomy is attached with the type of carbon atom, they are classified into so primary, secondary, and tertiary. So halogenatomy is attached with the primary carbon are called primary alkyl halides. Halogenatomy is attached with the secondary carbon atom are called secondary alkyl halides. Halogenatomy is attached with the tertiary carbon atom are called tertiary alkyl halides. Next two, based on halogen atoms. So alkyl halides are classified into three types: monohalogen derivatives, next dihalogen derivatives, next more than two, they are considered as polyhalogen derivatives. Monohalogen derivatives, dihalogen derivatives, polyhalogen derivatives. So it is also complicated. So monohalogen derivatives means containing only one halogen atom, containing only one halogen atom, containing only one halogen atom. So example, methyl chloride, CH3CN, ethyl chloride, C2H5CN. These are examples of our monohalo derivatives. Next one, dihalo means containing two halogen atoms. So these dihalogen atoms are classified into how many types? So dihalogen derivatives are two types. So both the halogen atoms are present on the same carbon atom, or both the halogen atoms are present on adjacent carbon atoms, is also complicated. So if both the halogen atoms are present on same carbon atom, they are called gem halides. If both the halogen atoms are present on adjacent carbon atoms, they are called vicinal. So gem halides and vicinal halides. Next one, next two. Polyhalogen derivatives means containing three or four or more than two. So in polyhalogen derivatives, trihalogen derivatives. Best example is chloroform, CHCl3. Common name is chloroform. So what is IUPAC name? Trichloromethane. IUPAC name is trichloromethane. Next CHBr3, tribromomethane. Next CHI3, it is called triiodomethane. Commonly it is also called iodoform. It is chloroform, it is bromoform, it is iodoform. These are examples for trihalogen. Next, in trihalogen derivatives, other example, that is, other example is Westrol. So, other example is, so Westrol. Westrol. So it is a C double bond C, it is a Cl, it is a Cl, next it is a Cl, it is a hydrogen. Trichloroethane, carbon-carbon containing double bond. So trichloroethane, commonly it is called Westrol. It is called Westrol. The next one is the, next one, tetrahalogen derivatives. Tetrahalogen derivatives means total number of halogens are four. So best example is carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. So CCl4, carbon tetrachloride is the common name. IUPAC name is tetrachloromethane. What is the IUPAC name? Tetrachloromethane. Next, the vapors of carbon tetrachloride are called, last week already completed, pyrene. Vapors of carbon tetrachloride, pyrene. So this vapors of carbon tetrachloride used in fire extinguishers. Okay, so CCl4. Next, other example, Westrol. Westrol. So Westrol is tetrachloro derivative. So IUPAC name is 1,1,2,2 tetrachloroethane. Tetrachloroethane. These two examples are also completed in the last week. So what is the IUPAC name? First carbon, 1,1. Second carbon also contains two halogens. So 1,1, 2,2, tetrachloroethane. Commonly it is called Westrol. So it is prepared from It is a preparator from acetylene. So acetylene reacts with chlorine, so it forms Vestron. So it is the property of acetylene. So acetylene formula C2H2O means carbon, carbon containing triple bond. It is acetylene common name. What is the IUPAC name? Ethyl. So this acetylene reacts with the chlorine. Acetylene reacts with the chlorine in the presence of halogen carriers like anhydrous aluminium chloride, anhydrous aluminium chloride AlCl3. So any unsaturated hydrocarbon, unsaturated compounds undergo addition reaction. So in the first step, one halogen, one chlorine is added to first carbon. Second chlorine is added to next carbon. In this addition reaction, one pi bond is broken. So carbon-carbon getting triple bond. One is sigma, remaining two are pi bonds. So one pi bond is broken. Here the first compound formed is CH, it is a Cl, double bond, CH, it is a Cl. So 1,2-dichloro, root word is E. Carbon-carbon containing a double bond. So it is 1,2-dichloroethene. 1,2-dichloroethene. It is also unsaturated compound because of it contains another pi bond. So it is also undergo addition reaction. It reacts with another chlorine molecule. So in the second step, so chlorine is added to first carbon, another chlorine is added to second carbon. So this pi bond is also broken. CH is Cl. It is a Cl. Single bond. CH is Cl. CH is Cl. So it is a 1,2-dichloroethene. 1,2-dichloro. Root word is eth. Carbon-carbon containing double bond. So it is called 1,2-dichloroethene. Next it is 1,1. 1,1. Next 2,2. Total number of chlorines 4. So 1,1, 2,2 tetrachloro. 1,1, 2,2 tetrachloro. Root word is eth. Carbon-carbon containing single bond. So 1,1, 2,2 tetrachloroethane. So it is also completed in the last week. The next one. Next, unsaturated alkyl halides or halogen derivatives. So unsaturated means unsaturated. So unsaturated halogen derivatives means unsaturated is carbon-carbon containing double bond or carbon-carbon containing triple bond. So double bond and triple bond. Double bonded compounds are called alkenes. Triple bonded compounds are called alkynes. So example, CH2, double bond CH2. It is ethylene. Okay. So in ethylene, one of the hydrogen is replaced by halogen. Halogens means either chlorine or bromine or iodine. So common name, what is the common name? Suppose here we take Cl. Common name is called vinyl chloride. What is the common name? Vinyl chloride. So vinyl chloride is the common name. Then what is the IUPAC name of this compound? What is the IUPAC name of this compound? It is the first carbon. Next it is the second carbon. So root word is eth. So chlorine is present. So it is chloro. Chloro, root word is eth. Carbon-carbon containing double bond. So chloroethene, commonly it is called vinyl chloride. So they are also called alkenyl halides. So these are also called alkenyl halides. These are called alkynyl halides. Example acetylene. CH triple bond CH. It is acetylene. One of the hydrogen is replaced by Cl. So it is ethinyl chloride. Ethinyl chloride. So alkynyl halides. Alkynyl halides. So it is alkynyl halides. It is alkenyl halides. Alkenyl halides. So this part is also completed. So it is a vinyl chloride, it is a very important component. The next one, allyl. So allyl chloride. So what is allyl group? Vinylic group means CH2 double bond CH, it is vinyl. So what is the IUPAC name of vinyl group? So what is the IUPAC name? Root word is eth. So carbon-carbon containing
double bond. So ethane, this is replaced by ammonia. So ethanol. So what is the IUPAC mass of an I? Ethanol. The next one, allyl. So what is allyl? CH2. Double bond CH. It is attached with CH2. This CH2 is attached with the halogen. So this group is called allyl. It is allyl. So common name is allyl chloride. What is the common name? Allyl chloride. So what is the IUPAC name of allyl? What is the IUPAC name of allyl? So it is considered as the first carbon. Only allyl. If it is a Cl, it is considered as first carbon. It is the second carbon. It is the third carbon. So 3-chloropropane or 3-chloro-1-propane. The next one is the CH3. CH double bond CH2. It is a Cl. So it is considered as allyl. So chlorine is attached with sp3 hybridized carbon. It is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. It is sp3 hydrogen carbon. It is sp2 hydrogen carbon. The next thing, the next compound here, Cl is attached with the sp2 hydrogen carbon. So it is also considered as vinyl. It is vinyl halide. It is allyl halide. So this part is also completed in the last week. So it is allyl chloride. Next one, it is a vinyl because of Cl is attached with the double bonded carbon means vinyl. If Cl is attached with the sp3 hydrogen carbon, which is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon, it is called allyl. So IUPAC nomenclature is also completed allyl. Next, in case of aromatic, so up to aromatic compounds completed. Aromatic means parent ring is benzene. So it is a benzene. Benzene formula C6H6. Cyclic structure. So it has 3 pi bonds. It is a aromatic compound. C6H6. Okay. So here, CH, each carbon is attached with one hydrogen, CH. So one of the hydrogen is replaced by chlorine or halogen. So it is called so halogen. So here, one of the hydrogen is replaced by Cl. It is called chlorobenzene. It is called chlorobenzene. It is called chlorobenzene. It is called chlorobenzene. If you take bromine, it is called bromobenzene. If you take iodine, it is called iodobenzene. So it is the chlorobenzene. So number have a possible monochloro derivatives of a number of possible monochloro derivatives of a number of monochloro derivatives of benzene. So how many monochloro derivatives are possible for benzene? Okay. So in benzene, all the six carbons are identical. Hybridization of all the carbon atoms sp2. So one of the hydrogen is replaced by Cl. So number of possible monochloro derivatives for benzene. So if this H is replaced by Cl, it is chlorobenzene. Whether it is chlorobenzene or 1-chlorobenzene or 6-chlorobenzene, it is considered as chlorobenzene. Suppose this hydrogen is replaced by Cl, it is also called chlorobenzene. Next, if this hydrogen is replaced by chlorine, so it is also chlorobenzene, but not it is 1-chlorobenzene, it is 2-chlorobenzene, it is 3-chlorobenzene, it is 4-chlorobenzene, it is 5-chlorobenzene, it is not 6-chlorobenzene. So only number of possible monochloro derivatives for benzene are only one possibility, that is chlorobenzene or halobenzene. Only one monohalogen derivative is possible. The next one, take dihalogen derivatives. Dihalogen means each carbon is attached with one hydrogen. So here, gem is not possible because of one hydrogen. Each carbon is attached with only one hydrogen. Only vicinal is possible. Suppose this hydrogen is replaced by Cl. Next, hydrogen is replaced from this adjacent carbon. It is adjacent carbon. It is also adjacent carbon. So it is called dichlorobenzene. Now mention the position. Like it is the first carbon. It is the second carbon. So it is called 1, 2 dichlorobenzene. It is called 1,2 dichloromethane. Okay. So instead of here, if a Cl is a substituted, this carbon means addition to carbon. So it is the benzene ring. It is the benzene ring. Okay. So it is a Cl. It is a Cl. So it is 1,2 dichloromethane to the first carbon. Next it is considered as the second carbon. So it is 1,2 dichloromethane. What is the name of this compound? It is the first carbon. It is the second carbon. It is also called 1,2 dichloromethane, but not 1,6 dichloromethane. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1,2 dichloromethane is correct, but not 1,6 dichloromethane is wrong. So 1,2, 1,6 dichloromethane is wrong. So it is also called 1,2 dichloromethane. So this position is also called ortho dichloromethane. So we know the positions of benzene has how many positions? It has 3 positions. So 1,2 positions are called the ortho positions. It is 1, it is 2. Next it is 1, it is 2. So these two are called ortho positions. These two are called ortho positions. It is ortho, it is ortho. The next one, it is a para position. Parallel to the substituent, it is considered as a para position. Dipole moment for para, isomer is 0. In between ortho and meta, these two are called meta position. So benzene has 2 ortho positions and 2 meta positions and 1 para position. So it is also called ortho dichlorobenzene common name. So ortho dichlorobenzene, ortho means, so represent only O, not 0. It is ortho means O. O dichlorobenzene means ortho dichlorobenzene. Means chlorine, both the chlorine atoms are present on adjacent carbon 1, 2 carbons. Okay? Right. So, number of possible dichloro derivatives for benzene. So, how many dichloro derivatives are possible for benzene? Number of possible dichloro derivatives for benzene. So dichloro means a substitute 3-2 chlorines. It is the benzene ring. Okay. Like it is the first halogen. Like it is the Cl. Next it is the second Cl. So what is the name of this compound? Ortho dichloro benzene, or IUPAC means 1,2 dichloro benzene. 1,2 dichloro benzene. Next, what is the second possibility? It is the first possibility. Next, the second possibility, both the chlorines takes on first and third carbons. Let it is the first carbon. Next, it is the third carbon. So, it is meta position. Third position is meta. So, 1,3, 1,5 are meta positions. It is 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, it is 5, it is 6. So, it is 2, it is the third position, fourth position, fifth position, sixth position. So 2 and 6 positions are ortho, 3 and 5th positions are meta, fourth position is para, it has only 1 para position. So it is a meta dichlorobenzene common name, meta dichlorobenzene, meta dichlorobenzene. But what is the IUPAC name? Mention the position. It is the first carbon, it is the third carbon. So 1,3 dichloro benzene. 1,3 dichlorobenzene. So it's the first possibility. 1,2 dichlorobenzene. Next one. 1,3 dichlorobenzene. Next, what is the third possibility? What is the third possibility? 1,3. After 1,3, 1,4 dichlorobenzene. That is the first position. It is the second position. Third position. It is the fourth position. So 1,4 dichloro benzene, or it is also called para dichlorobenzene. It's also called paranitrobenzene. Next, any other possibility? So take fourth possibility. So chlorine is substituted on, so fourth carbon completed. If it is substituted on fifth carbon, is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, like this fifth carbon. Suppose chlorine is substituted. It is also meta position. So it is also called meta dichlorobenzene. So now take the number and give the first carbon, give the second carbon, give the third carbon. So it is also 1,3 dichlorobenzene. So it is 1,3 dichlorobenzene. So it is not considered as another possibility. The next one, if you take next possibility in 106th position, so it is chlorine. Next it is chlorine. So these two are ortho position. So it is the first carbon, it is the second carbon. So it is also ortho dichlorobenzene or 1,2 dichlorobenzene. So already 1,2 dichlorobenzene. So it is not considered another possibility. So number of possible dichlorobenzenes for benzene are 3. So for benzene, how many monochloro derivatives are possible? Only one monochloro derivative is possible. Whereas dichloro derivatives, number of possible dichloro derivatives are 3. They are 1,2 dichlorobenzene or ortho dichlorobenzene. Second one, 1,3 dichlorobenzene or meta dichlorobenzene. Next, fourth possibility, third possibility, 1,4 dichlorobenzene or is also called para dichlorobenzene. So number of possible monoderivatives for benzene are 1. Next, number of possible dichloro derivatives are 3. So 1,2, 1,3 and 1,4. Okay. Next one. So in halo arenes means halogen is attached with benzene ring. So halo arenes. Chlorine is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. Chlorine is attached with or halogen is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon because of in benzene, all the 6 carbon atoms undergo sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. Okay, right. The next one, Ronchyl halides. So, in the last week, this work is also completed. Ronchyl halides also completed in the last week. Ronchyl means ryl group is attached with alkyl group. Ryl group means benzene. It is attached with methyl group. It is attached with methyl group. So commonly it is called toluene or methyl benzene. IUPAC name is a methyl benzene. Commonly. So it is a methyl benzene. So CH3 group. One of the hydrogen is replaced by Cl. It is considered as methyl benzene or is also called toluene. Next. So methyl benzene. So, in methyl benzene, one of the hydrogen is replaced. It is called benzyne. It is called benzyne. So, here, in a benzene ring, that is C6H6, it is a benzene. In a benzene, one hydrogen atom is removed. The remaining species is C6H5-. It is called phenyl. Not benzyne, it is called a phenyl. CH4 is a methane. In a methane, one hydrogen atom is removed. The remaining species is called a methyl. It is also called alkylenes. Methyl, ethyl, propyl. Propyls are two types, N-propyl, isopropyl. Next, butyl. Butyls are four types, N-butyl, isobutyl, secondary butyl, and tertiary butyl. So it is a methyl. Whereas in benzene, one hydrogen atom is removed from benzene. It is not benzyne. One hydrogen atom is removed from methane. It is called methyl. If one hydrogen atom is removed from benzene, it is not benzyne. It is called phenyl. Not called as a benzyne. Benzyl is different. So C6H5, it is called phenyl. Means in benzene, one of the hydrogen atom is replaced. It is called phenyl. Next. CH3 is a methyl benzene. In a methyl benzene, one of the hydrogen atom is removed. It is called benzyl. Okay, so benzyl means C6H5 is not benzyl. C6H5 is called phenyl. Next, in toluene means methyl benzene, one hydrogen atom is replaced. One hydrogen atom is removed, a remaining species is called benzyl. This benzyl is attached with Cl. It is called benzyl bromide. It is called benzyl chloride. Benzyl chloride. So it is called benzyl chloride. Okay. So C6H5 is called phenyl. Benzyl means C6H5CH2 is called benzyl. So it is called benzyl chloride. So what is the IUPAC name of benzyl chloride? It is considered as methyl derivative. So chlorophenyl C6H5 is called phenyl. So chlorophenyl methane. So commonly it is called benzyl chloride. Common name is also very important. Generally, frequently we use the common name. So benzyl chloride. What is the formula of benzyl chloride? C6H5. It is a phenyl. Next to CH2, it is a benzyl. It is Cl. So C6H5, CH2 is a benzyl. Is attached with the Cl. It is called benzyl chloride. IUPAC name is chlorophenyl methane. This methyl group carbon, only one carbon. So methane is attached with one chlorine and one phenyl ring. So chlorophenyl methane. So commonly it is called benzyl chloride. The next one. In toluene means methyl benzene. In toluene or in methyl benzene, it is the benzene ring. It is CH3, it is methyl benzene. So here carbon is attached with how many hydrogens? 3 hydrogens. If one hydrogen atom is replaced by halogen, it is called benzyl halide. If we use chlorine, it is called benzyl chloride. Okay, next. If 2 hydrogens are replaced by 2 halogens, means 2 chlorines or 2 bromines, means a formula C6H5CHCl2, or it is also considered as it is a benzene ring. Okay, next it is a CHCl2, means both the halogens are present on same carbon. If both the halogens are present on same carbon atom, it is Gemma Revisional. Both the halogens are present on same carbon, it is called Gem. Adjacent carbon, it is vicinal. So it is called C6H5CHCl2. Only one hydrogen is replaced by chlorine. It is called benzyl chloride. If two hydrogens are replaced by Cl, so it is called, it is, so if two halogens are, it is dihalogen derivative. If both the halogens are present on same carbon means it is considered as Gem. So it is called benzol chloride. So it is called benzol chloride. So what is the common name? It is called benzol chloride. Benzol means 2 chlorines attached with the same carbon. It is called benzol chloride. Then what is the IUPAC name? It is benzyl chloride. It is called benzol chloride. Common names are very, very important. Okay? So, in the organic chemistry, don't neglect the nomenclature also. So, compounds also very important. Nomenclature is also very important. So, benzyl chloride, C6H5C, these compounds are frequently used in the preparation of phenol, preparation of benzaldehyde, preparation of acetophenol. Okay? So, it is a benzyl chloride. It is called a benzol. What is the IUPAC name of benzyl chloride? 1,1-dichloro-1 or dichlorophenyl methane. Dichloro or 1,1-dichloro-phenyl methane. Both the halogens are present on same. So dichlorophenyl methane or 1,1-dichloro. Next one, phenyl methane. Next one, in so methyl benzene, all the 3 hydrogens are replaced by 3 halogens. All the 3 hydrogens are replaced by 3 halogens. That is a trihalogen derivative. Trihalogen derivative. So it is methyl benzene or toluene. In methyl benzene, all the 3 hydrogens are replaced by halogens. Here we use chlorine. So it is called benzochloride. It is called benzochloride. So benzyl chloride, benzol chloride, benzochloride. So benzyl chloride is monochloro derivative. Next one, benzoyl chloride is trichloroderivative. Next one, benzochloride is trichloroderivative. Benzochloride is the trichloroderivative. Okay, so these are the common names and the IUPAC names are the compounds. The next one, next one, take another example. So benzyl, benzol, and benzo complete. The next one, take another example. Take another example. So benzene ring is attached with It is a benzene ring. So what is the IUPAC name of this compound? Like the first compound. So it is a benzene ring. It is a CH2. Next it is a CH2. Instead of a Cl, suppose here we take Br. Here we take Br. Next to second compound, it is a CH double bond. CH double bond. Next to CH2 Br. Like it is the second compound. It is the first compound. It is the second compound. So what is write the IUPAC name of first compound and second compound? Try to write the IUPAC name of the first compound and second compound. What is the IUPAC name of first compound? Okay. So it is considered as the first carbon. Halogen is attached with this carbon. It is considered as first carbon. It is the first carbon. It is the second carbon. It is the third carbon. So IUPAC name is 1-bromo. Next one. It is the third carbon. Phenyl is attached with the third carbon. So 3-phenyl. 1-bromo. 3-phenyl. Next root wire. Root wire contains how many carbon? 1, 2, 3 carbons. So root wire is from carbon-carbon containing either single bond or double bond. Carbon-carbon containing single bond. So propane suffix is A-N-A. So what is the IUPAC name of first compound? 1-bromo-3-phenyl. 1-bromo-3-phenyl. Root wire contains 3 carbons. Carbon-carbon containing single bond. So it is called 1-bromo-3-phenyl. Okay, right. What is the IUPAC name of second compound? So here, it is the first carbon or it is the first carbon? Here it is considered as the first carbon. It is the second carbon. It is the third carbon. What is the difference? Here it contains a functional group. Double bond is also considered as a functional group. So if I give you numbering from right hand side from this side, so double bond, position of double bond in second position. Next one, if numbering is given from this carbon, double bond position in first position. So according to list sub rule, so here first double bond or functional group gets less number. So it is first carbon, it is second carbon, it is third carbon. Next, then write the IUPAC name of this compound. Follow the alphabetical order. So first Br. What is the position of bromine? At the third carbon or third position. So what is the IUPAC name of this compound? 3-bromo. 3-bromo. Next is the first carbon. Here phenyl is attached with the first carbon. Here phenyl means benzene ring is attached with the first carbon. So 3-bromo. 1-phenyl. Root word is 3. So prop. Root word means containing 3 carbons. So prop. Root word is prop. Carbon-carbon containing. Either single bond or double bond. Double bond. For a double bond the suffix is. For a double bond the suffix is. E-N-E. For single bond A-N-E. For a double bond E-N-E. For a triple bond Y-N-E. So propane. Is it correct? Or N-E? Small mistake. Is it correct IUPAC name or wrong? It has a slight mistake. So propene is wrong. Mention the position of double bond
It is the first position. It is the second position. So 1-propene, or it is also called prop 1E. It is the correct name. Okay. So propene is wrong because of we have mentioned the position of a double bond. It is the first position. If double bond is present here, it is the second position. So it is called propene is wrong. Prop 1E, or it is also called 1-propene. It is also called 1-propene. So it is a nomenclature of aromatic compound. These are examples, a few examples. Okay. The next, another part is also covered in the last week. So halogen atom is attached with. So among the following, here I give some compounds. First one is the alkyl halides. Alkyl halide is in the first one. Or multiple answer, it is A. Alkyl halides. Next B, alkyl halides. Next one, vinyl halide. Vinyl halide. Next C, allyl halide. Allyl halide. Next fourth one, aryl halide. Aryl halide. Next compound E, alkyl halide. Alkyl halide. Alkyl halide. Okay? Right. Here, halogen atom is attached with each type of carbon. Halogen is attached with each type of carbon. Each type of carbon means what is the correct matching? Halogen atom is attached with halogen atom, or halogen is attached with either sp hybridized carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon or sp3 hybridized carbon. Halogen is attached with each type of carbon. Each type of carbon means either sp hybridized carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon or sp3 hybridized carbon. First one. So in alkyl halides, halogen is attached with either sp3 hybridized carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon or sp hybridized carbon. So first we get alkyl halide. Alkyl halide means RX. Take example, it is the A first compound. So example, methyl chloride or ethyl chloride. CH3Cl or ethyl chloride. Ethyl means CH3, CH2Cl. So here, chlorine is attached with this carbon. Tetravalency of this carbon is satisfied by only single bonds. So in alkyl halides, in the first compound A, in alkyl halides, halogen is attached with sp3 hybridized carbon. This identification is also very important because of, so nature of, means properties, depends on halogen is attached with either sp3 hybridized carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon. So reactivity depends on type of bond. So here halogen is attached with carbon. So here example, alkyl halide means CH3Cl, C2H5Cl, propyl chloride, butyl chloride, next amyl chloride. These are the examples. Next one, second one, vinyl halides. We know the vinyl group and IUPAC name of vinyl. So vinyl means CH2 double bond CH. It is a vinyl group. So it is a Cl. Here chlorine is attached with sp2 means a double bonded carbon. The carbon which is attached with 1-pi bond, its hybridization is sp2 hybridization. Here halogen is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. So it is called a vinyl. Next one, CH3 double bond CH Cl. It is a vinyl or allyl. So it is either a vinyl halide or allyl halide. It is also considered as vinyl, but not allyl. Vinyl means halogen is attached with double bonded carbon.
If halogen is attached with the double bonded carbon atom, it is considered as vinyl. Okay, so it is not considered as anion because of Cl is attached with. So what is the hybridization of double bonded carbon? No doubt, carbon is attached with only one pi bond. It is attached with one pi bond. Its hybridization is sp2. So in vinyl halides, halogen actually is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. In vinyl halides, halogen is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. It is also considered as a vinyl. Next, what is C? Third one. C. C is allyl. What is C? Allyl. Okay. So allyl means it is a CH3. Next. So it is CH2. Next it is CH3. It is propane. So CH2 double bond CH. CH2 double bond CH. It is CH2. Here halogen is attached with Cl or Br or I. Okay. So it is called allyl. Allyl means halogen is attached with sp3 hybridized carbon because of this chlorine is not attached with any pi bond. It is a sigma bond. Hydrogen and carbon contains always a sigma bond. So here halogen is attached with sp3 hybridized carbon. It is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. Then it is called allyl. So in allyl halides, halogen is attached with either sp3 hybridized carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon. sp3 hybridized carbon. It is a very important example. Allyl halide is a very important example. Okay, now the next one. Aryl halide means halogen is attached with benzene ring. It is a benzene ring. Halogen is attached with the benzene ring. One of the hydrogen is replaced by halogen, either Cl or Br or I. In benzene, all the 6 carbon atoms undergo sp2 hybridization. We know the ratio of hybrid orbitals and non-hybrid orbitals. So in benzene, sigma bonds and pi bonds. What is the ratio of number of sigma bonds and pi bonds in benzene? So benzene formula C6H6. So number of sigma and pi bonds present in benzene. So it is the benzene ring, formula C6H6, so CH, next it is a CH, so it has a double bonds in alternate position. So it contains how many sigma bonds? 12 sigma bonds, carbon-carbon containing sigma bond. Carbon and hydrogen is also containing sigma bond. So it contains 6 CC sigma bonds. And it contains 6 CH sigma bonds. So total number of sigma bonds are 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 CC sigma bonds. 6 CH sigma bonds. Total number of sigma bonds 12. Number of pi bonds 1. 2, 3. So number of pi bonds 3. Number of sigma bonds 12. So what is the ratio? Ratio of number of sigma bonds and pi bonds 12:3. So 4:1. So what is the ratio of sigma and pi bonds in benzene? 4:1. Because of total number of sigma bonds 12, number of pi bonds 3. So ratio is 4:1. So in benzene, all the 6 carbon atoms undergo sp2 hybridization. So in haloarenes, Cl or halogen is attached with sp2 hybridized carbon. So in aryl halides, halogen is attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon. Next one, aryl. So it is aryl, alkyl or aryl. Aryl means benzyl chloride. Example, aryl means take toluene. Methyl benzene is also called toluene. It is a benzene ring. So methyl benzene is also called toluene. In methyl benzene, one of the hydrogen is replaced by halogen. Here we take chlorine. So what is the common name? So it is called a benzyl chloride. What is the common name? Benzyl chloride. So what is the common name? Benzyl chloride. So chlorine is attached with this carbon. Here this carbon is attached to only sigma bonds, no pi bonds. No pi bond means what is the hybridization? sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. So it's also important concept. So in alkyl halides, halogenated is attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon. In vinyl halides, if halogen is attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon, they are called vinyl halides, aliphatic, in case of aliphatic. Next one, allyl halide means halogen is attached with the sp3 hybridized carbon, which is attached with the sp2 hybridized carbon, they are called allyl. So it is sp3, allyl, it is aromatic, it is also sp3, it is also sp2, but it is aliphatic, it is aromatic. Okay, now? Next one is the alkyl. So alkyl halides behaves like saturated compounds, not aromatic compounds. Okay, no? So nomenclature and the types of classification of alkyl halides perfectly completed up to JE level and NET level. So in the next class, isomerism. Possible isomerism in alkyl halides. So structural isomerism. The next one is the stereoisomerism. So in the first part we will cover only the structural isomerism. So chain is possible, next only position is possible. So in the structural isomerism, only chain isomerism is possible and the position isomerism. So in the next class, so isomerism, the next two, what is the type of bonding and what is the bond length, what is the bond energy and what is the dipole moment, then we will go to methods of preparations of ethyl chloride. Okay, right. So next coming weekend syllabus, type one, introduction to Henry's law, means concentration term, types of solutions. Next concentration terms, so four concentration terms. Next one, Henry's law, solubility of gaseous in liquids, up to Henry's law. Okay, for the JE students, for PCMC students, so CET exam is for 60 months, for 60 weeks. The next one for NEET students, for PCMB students, NEET exam. So track to syllabus, introduction. So bonding means hybridization types of type of bonding, sigma bonds, pi bonds, nature of bond. The next one, nomenclature, classification of alkyl halides. So up to the bonding. The next one, isomerism. Next, methods of preparations of ethyl chloride. So ethyl chloride has only 5 methods. So in the almost by Saturday, methods of preparations also completed. So introduction to this part and tomorrow's class, that is isomerism, and day after tomorrow class Saturday, preparation of alkyl halides. So it is the second track syllabus. So introduction to nomenclature classification, first part, second part, isomerism. Next, the third part, methods of preparations of ethyl chloride. So track one, introduction to Henry's law. Next, introduction to preparations of ethyl chloride. Okay, right.